Okay, we are audible, right? Good afternoon, all. Sorry for the technical problem we were facing yesterday. We were trying some new platform wherein there are more users can be, there were 300 users can participate. So that's it.
Dear sir,
Anyways, now we'll not waste
please
time.
inform
Let's
all
start.
to stop their video.
Yeah, everybody stop their video so that, the less bandwidth would be going. Yeah. Yes, you can start, Viva.
Yes. So, sir, should I start from start again, like points to be covered?
No required, not required points to be covered. Now we can start directly.
So, the first thing we were going to show you is the screen recorder.
Unmute yourself.
Yes, sir. Muted back. I've unmuted myself. Okay, so first thing we were going to show you was a screen recorder. Sir, are you able to see the recorder now or no? I don't think so. I'm not able to hear the voice in behind. Are you able to see the screen recorder?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
No.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, okay, thank you. So the first tool we were going to show you was a screen recorder. So for screen recorder is a free online app. You can download it. It's Kinomatic. Show you this also. You can download. Then that tool first, the first thing is it allows you to set the screen for which it's supposed to record. So first thing is that it allows you to set a screen in which you want to, let's say, record. So now I want to record this presentation, or I want to, first I'll check, first I can select whether I want to record screen, whether I want to record my own webcam, like my own webcam video, or whether I want to. So whenever I choose both, then I'll be able to also choose my webcam, and while recording, then the students will be able to see me. Like during the presentation or in the recording. Say I've clicked on record. So I get a timer and then I can record. Now let's say I'm presenting solar system and this is the chapters. So solar system, welcome students to solar system, something like that. Just make a short recording so that I can show you. Okay. So in this way, now first is the Jupiter planet. Jupiter planet is the largest planet in our solar system and it has 61 moons. So let's say I'm presenting something like this. There's an option of pause. You can click over there. You can pause. Then if you want, like, you want to record again, you can click on record.
Viva,
Yes,
we are
sir.
not able to see this pause. You have started recording of video, you mean?
Yes, sir. I've
No.
started video recording of the video.
We are not able to see that controls. You need to, reduce the size of the screen and show. Where are the controls? At the top?
No, sir, controls are in the bottom.
Also, we are not able to see that controls.
So able to see that now, sir?
No.
Let's reduce the screen.
No. Still, it's not visible.
Okay, so I think so as we are on one call again, maybe that might be the issue.
Here we can see small buttons, recording, pause, but that is for different thing. That is for meeting.
Yeah, that's the controls are recording.
No, that is for meeting recording thing.
Okay,
You
okay.
still use the selection, you reduce the selection size. Whatever you have
I've reduced.
selected.
Okay, I can reduce it, sir. I think I've almost reduced it too. Right now. I've reduced the selection size, sir, right now. But I don't think the controls will be able to show in share screen.
Okay, so the controls are not able to be seen.
Okay, so if you see the screen, there the controls are very small. Like there's one control called as record. It's a very it's a round red tab with REC written on it and big one, so you can it's easily visible. When you actually start using it hands on, I think you'll be able to see the tool over there. Then for there's a record button. That record you can resume the recording. Like let's say I'm resuming this recording.
Can you take a print screen?
And once I've done,
can you take a print screen and just copy it somewhere and you can show that print screen.
Okay, so a screenshot.
Yeah, screenshot. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. 1 second. I'll try to take a screenshot.
Okay. Copy it in a paint and you can show it. Or if it's available.
Screen-o-matic. Yeah, 1 second. I can open that. O-matic and share that. Okay, I'll just stop my share. I think I'll stop my share. Okay, I think I've saved it.
Okay,
yes.
No, Manoj is speaking.
Hello.
Yeah, Manoj is speaking.
Yes, Mr. Manoj.
Meanwhile, you just clear about our motto behind this and what will be the purpose of this photo.
Okay.
So now, are you able to see?
Yes. We are able to see. Yeah.
Okay. So I'll just move. Okay, so I've taken a screenshot of this. So sir, Manoj sir, to answer your question, the motto behind it is that the teachers should be able to record their teaching videos, and we are just giving them a brief on what they can record, how they can record, or which tools they can use.
So basically, right, this what happens is in this screeno-matic, we can have a presentation and simultaneously our video would also be recorded, so that it gives an effective video learning video kind of that can be created through this.
And also for live sessions, there is a lot of issues happening, saying that the students are not joining or they're missing out on certain parts due to connectivity issues. So when you pre-record those videos,
yes, additional option. Can you once show the one final video you have created through this?
I'll show that as well. First, I'll show them the options. So there's a record button, like I said. You can click on it, start and stop, pause that particular presentation. Furthermore, whenever you are done, you can just click on done, and then it shows you options. Like when you click on done, it shows you whether you want to edit that video, whether you want to save and upload. So in case if you have any problem, now let's say I'll again go back to my stop share. Are you able to see the window, sir? Screenomatic window?
No, only blue screen is seen. Blue screen, and your webcam is seen, but
yeah,
only blue screen. But behind that, only blue screen is seen.
Okay, I'll stop my share and I'll again share. So right now, share something. So are you able to see, sir, right now?
Yes.
Just the screen.
Yeah. Yes, I can see you. And your screen,
So that is right now. I'm just clicking on done, and once I click on done, there's an option of edit video or save and upload or quick share. So generally, I go to edit video because in case if you have screen sharing is stopped. Okay, I have to share my screen again. So are you able to see the web launcher screen?
Not yet.
One sec. I will just I'll open that. So now are you able to see my web launcher screen?
Yeah, now we are able to see your
web launcher. Okay, so in this way, once you click on edit, then you will be able to see, you can review once your own
record. Now let's say I'm presenting solar system, and this is the chapter. Solar system.
So here we can see how the, automatically our presentation is captured, and the video also is captured of the teacher.
You can edit it or you can add captions. Furtherly, if you want to add captions somewhere, particularly if you have missed out a point and you want to add captions, that option is also there. If you want to add some music behind it, behind that particular recording, that option is also there. Further, I think there is an upgraded plan where you can do more, like add green filters, watermarks that you can explore. Further, the best part about it is that there is a tab called as upload on YouTube. Now, if you have your school's own teaching, like own YouTube channel, you simply click on upload to YouTube. And then it asks you if you want, like you can change the title if you want. You can change the title as a trial video, just to trial video. And change the title. You can keep the, for privacy, you can keep the video as private or unlisted. Right now it's by default unlisted. I've set it for like that, but you can keep it unlisted. So for whenever it's unlisted, it will be only viewed by the people, by you and whomever you share the link to. Or if you have embedded that link in your LMS system, then your students will be able to see that video only. It won't be public. Like no one else on YouTube can view that video. Similar click, now I'm doing a publish. So right, and stop the publish currently. But in this way, you can easily publish your own video, add your own videos to your YouTube school channel.
Viva, suppose how do I map my this account? Account means
yes, for mapping YouTube account. Whenever you click on YouTube. Like right now, whenever you click on the YouTube button.
So here it is written school admin. Suppose I want to change
that
it.
That is up. My channel. I'll just, one sec. I'll open my YouTube. I'll stop the share over here. So whenever you click on upload to YouTube, it automatically opens your YouTube, whichever you might have on your desktop. I'll share my screen. I'll show you. So it automatically opens the YouTube, which is there on your PC or on your desktop. So for that, the YouTube, you first have to log in with your ID, password, like, whichever you're using for uploading that particular videos. So over here, I logged in as school admin. In my YouTube, I've signed in as school admin and I have created my own channel where I am seeing like your channel. So over there in your channel, you can get your ID linked to your school's YouTube channel. And then furthermore, those videos will be uploaded to your channel. So I think I have done a trial recording with this. Can show you that. So for linking your YouTube channel, you have to first log into your YouTube where in your desktop or laptop. Then you have to create a channel if you don't have a channel. If you already have a school's channel, then you have to simply link your ID with that channel. And then whenever you click on upload to YouTube, it will directly get uploaded to your channel. So I've created a video with this. Now I did it using my mobile app as well. That's also possible.
Your video is not visible here. Your video.
One second, stop my share and I'll again share.
No, your video means in that video, your video like.
Okay, sir, I've not uploaded. I didn't upload. I didn't go through because it takes little time to upload the video.
I don't think so. It would take much time. You can keep it in uploading in back in the current video.
I'll try to publish it. 1 minute. I think so. It will get done. Just 1 minute. Stop my share. Okay, sharing. So I'm uploading my video, trial video. It'll just take 2 minutes or so. So any queries regarding this, like any questions regarding
What is the software name? How to download it? How to use it? Just explain it again. You're not able to get it.
Okay.
What is the costing? What is the pricing? Or how is it? How is the usage? So please explain that again. Till the video gets uploaded, you explain us this part.
So the app is named as Screenomatic. When you go to screenomatic.com, you can there's a option called as launch free recorder, and there's also upgrade recorder if you want. For the pricing, so for the free version, you can record up to 15 minutes, And there's an option of recording to YouTube as well.
Even 15 minutes per video, one video.
Yeah, per video, sir. Per video.
So we can have unlimited videos of 15 minutes.
Yeah, you can have unlimited videos for 15 minutes.
Okay.
So over here, you can see whichever are available that you can record with the window for full screen. You can do zoom in while recordings. You can trim the recordings with editor. You can add captions. You can save it to your desktop. And you can publish it to YouTube or Screenomatic. And you can also do a quick share to Facebook, Twitter, and Google Classroom as well. So these all features are available with the free version. Now for the deluxe version, the more
I think free version also is enough. You know, basic free version is enough.
Only for a lengthy video, if they want, then they can take a deluxe version. It's just $1 per month, $1.65.
Only so hardly 100 rupees per month.
Yeah, so if the school registers for a year or so, then one account can be operated by all the teachers in consideration.
Right.
Yeah, so in for free recorders, there's also an option that you can view videos on virtually any device. Then Google single sign-on is also there. Then you can store videos for same lessons, but create video channels for lessons and chapters. Like in case teachers want to create different lessons and to keep those video, whenever they're creating, they want an option that video should go under that particular lesson. Then she can do that. She can create lessons and videos and
fine. Fine. Now, how to log in and how do we proceed further? Like what is this? Now we have gone to this website. What is the next step? You
so
log out.
The next step would be.
You log out from your account.
Yeah.
It's okay if you log out, right?
Yeah, it's okay. I think, I hope so. Because this application is running. Yeah, the trial video is done. So I don't think there's an issue.
Okay, you log out.
Okay. Yeah, so I've logged out.
You can note down this website. In chat box also, you can copy this. Okay. Yeah, I can do that. I can send it. Fine. Yes. You proceed.
So for first, go to screenomatic.com, then sign up. It's free. Like I said, the sign up is free. I'll just show you what you need. You can sign up with your Google account easily, or you just have to give your email ID and password. That's all for signing up. But I think most will go or sign up with Google. So when you sign up with Google, I think
Up with Google is better, so that automatically YouTube and everything is linked, so that, you know, again, we don't have to link YouTube channel and everything
gets automatically synced to it. So signing up with Google is better, or at least with the Google account you are using actively for your school work. So yeah, like I said, I'm doing first name, last name, and I'm just, let's say I'm creating an account for this channel. Created it for my name. You haven't uploaded any recordings. I signed in. I can set up. As when you sign up with Google, I don't think so, sir. You need another password for it.
Mm-hmm.
I signed it.
Some file gets downloaded. File gets downloaded on your desktop, right?
Yeah, there's a it looks like a button. Your file gets when you, that's a launcher.
Yes.
So over here, over here there's an option called as launch recorder. Can you see the video tab?
Yes,
or even if you directly go to the screenomatic.com also, there's an option called as launcher. That's also there. This is a little small. Over here it says like start. Over here, the first thing is start recording for free, and then launch free recorder.
Okay.
That is more visible, but even after you sign in, there's an option over here with the window bar which says launch recorder or capture screenshot.
Okay, so we need to click on that, right? Launch recorder. And
yes,
I think
yes,
one
click on that, then it get downloads and you have to run that in your desktop.
Yeah, one file would get downloaded on your desktop. Once it would get downloaded, and next time onwards, if you want to record, you can just click on that icon and you can run it. Right. I'm right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, yeah. And yeah, you can show now. So this is how we need to do it. It's simple and very straightforward. And it's a very good effective tool for making good videos. Yeah, so
now I'm playing the video. I'm playing the video which we made currently. We made the video.
Now let's say I'm presenting solar system. And this is the chapter. First is the Jupiter planet. So let's say I'm presenting something like this. There's an option of pause. Let's say I'm resuming this recording.
So I just made a small trial video so that I can show you. I think that's it.
Yes. Hope everybody had understood this. Any query on this, we can take it. So this
is adding this tool.
Yeah. Yes, any feedback? How did you find this tool?
Teachers, you need to speak so we know whether you find it useful or not, or whether it's a little more hard for you to grasp. But I think it's very user-friendly and it's very easy in terms of video recording. Okay, it was very okay. So Shilpi ma'am said it's helpful for us.
You can try it, and so if there are any queries, we can help you out again.
Yeah, if any queries regarding it, we can help you out. It's very easy, but if there are queries, we can help you out. So that was for your desktop. Now most of you might be using mobile phones.
Screen not appearing.
Hello. Okay, sir, can you mute everyone?
Yeah.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
That's what Vibhav ma'am was saying, that most of the teachers are using mobile phones. So is it possible to use this app through the mobile while teaching?
Yes, Linomatic is available for mobile, but for mobile we have one more very user friendly tool called as X Recorder. I'm going to show you that now.
You are showing another app on mobile. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
So I have made a video prior with X Recorder. So I'll just show you show you the pre-made video, and I can see how it looks like after. So I've made this with my mobile phone with using the X Recorder.
Cell cycle works. What are the differences between the cell cycle and your short explanation? So today, first, there are four phases of the cell cycle, as you can see in the diagram. There's a shear phase, S phase, G2 phase. And M phase, or you're able to see my diagram. And the parents can define that. So in that cell, what happens in the G2 phase is all the cellular contents inside the cell, excluding the chromosomes, that is everything inside the cell organelles, cell organism, all of those gets duplicated. The first phase, that is in the G2 phase.
We can capture a camera also here, as in it was available in. Yes.
I've not captured my camera in this video. Over here, I've just shown an image and I'm annotating. Trying to highlight as I go. Whichever points I want to explain, I can click on that or draw on it so that they know. Okay. For example, over here.
Now, first, we in the phase, we created all the cell organelles or all the.
You can draw something like this. You can, when you're doing an explanation, you can draw and you can give
one chromosome. Duplication happens to two chromosomes. Now, we have duplicated or replicated all the material required to create another new cell. So, furthermore,
So there's something, yeah. So there's an app called a screen recorder. Sorry, X recorder. I'm saying X screen recorder. Yeah. So there's an app called as X recorder. You can download it on your mobile phones. I'll just stop my share. I can share my phone. So sorry to interrupt. Can you please share the Zoom link? One of the teachers is okay.
Yeah.
One second, I'll open that. Open my phone. Oh, why is it open? Okay. Share my screen. So, in my, if you're seeing able to see my phone. There's an app called as X Recorder. So open that.
Yeah, can you show it on Play Store? Or have you shown it? I missed that. How to search it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Have you shown how to download from Play Store? So what they have searched in Play Store?
No, sir, I have not shown that. Yes. Go to Play Store. I've already installed it, but we'll send you a link regarding downloading that particular. You can just search for it as well. X recorder. That's better. So this is the app. It's called as X recorder. You can search on your Google Play and simply download that app. I'm opening it. Because I've already downloaded it. So I'll first be able to see the videos that I have made priorly. Now, let's say I want to make a video. Okay. So now I'll first open an image which I want to take a video of. In this particular process. So I think I closed my recorder or something. Let me see. Start now. Yeah, I had to give the permission first. I think my tab went up. One sec. I'll just go back again because I think my tab that comes on the left, if I took it out. Okay. So right now, I think by mistake, the tab that is generally required, I have moved it up. Okay. So when, let's say I'm going back to my image and now I want to record it. So the tab is went up. Generally the tab is on your left hand side. So it will give you a timer to start. So I'm recording currently. And now let's say I want to explain or highlight something in that particular. I can change the size of my highlight. I can change the color of my highlight.
You're not able to see your mobile screen is just seeing your desktop.
Okay, it's not visible.
Okay. I think because of multiple shares. Okay, so are you able to see my screen now?
Yes.
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 Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So let's say I want to open, I'm opening this image and I want to record this. So there's a tab above. I've already started recording. I'll have to again do it.
I think there's icon here. Vibha, this icon is there on the left hand side. So,
yeah, there's an icon on the left, but I have moved it by mistake or something. So over here, there's a tab called as record. Now you'll see a timer running. Let's say I'm recording this, and in between, whenever I want to highlight a particular point, I can simply highlight it. I can change the color of it. I can change the size of it. I can highlight those things while explaining, while teaching. And once I've done with the video, I can simply stop it. That video now will be able to see that video.
How to zoom?
I can share it. I can.
How to zoom a particular
part? Better. Sir, I didn't understand.
No, if a particular, now it's a big screen, right? If I want to zoom out, zoom into a particular part of this image.
Yeah. So that can be done. Like, again, I'll start a recording. Let's say I'm starting a recording again.
And a camera, how to record ourselves. Yeah.
So that settings have to be enabled first of all. Then right now I have not enabled my camera, so I'll stop my record. I'll show you how you can enable camera as well if you want your own video to be seen. So go to your X recorder.
Again, we are not again this only one screen we are seeing.
Yes. Share has stopped. Yeah, my share has stopped. Okay, so I have enabled my recorder. I'll just change it again. When you download the recorder, it asks you whether you want to do only audio or you want to do audio and video. So once I think I had done audio, but then I had to go to settings again and then furthermore download it.
Have you shared your screen? We are not able to see.
So are you able to see me like in the desktop?
Oh, well, the screen is loading. Yeah, now I'm able to see.
Yeah. So in this way now, what I did, I'll again go to the screen recorder and show. There's some advertisements. Okay. So right now I had not activated beforehand my video. So in the settings option, there's an option over here that do you want to upload, start recording mode, or do you want to record audio and record video? So I've enabled the record audio, and further than if I want to record my own video as well, there's an option right now. I think camera, yeah, in tools there's an option called as camera. When you switch it off, you won't be able to see me. Now when I turn it back on, you'll be able to see me. So in this way, if you want your own video also to record simultaneously with the particular teaching session, that can happen. Now let's see, we are again going back to that image and I'll start the record. So now I can explain this diagram. Now if I want to zoom in and zoom out, that can happen. I can zoom in or zoom out. Then I can also, if I want to highlight a particular point, I can highlight it. If I don't want it, I can erase it. There's a tab on the down. I don't know if you're able to see the tab, but there's a tab where you can actually choose the colors which you want. So are you able to see me?
Your screen is got freezed kind of. Yeah, just one screen.
Yeah, my screen is freezing. Even for visor, that's only happening. I think my screen gets freezed.
So basically, this is how it is. It means when you're using it, so everything, you know, you can make use of this and create effective videos. Yes, I think Jyoti ma'am, you have raised your hand. You have any query?
Yes, actually, whatever we are doing on that screen, that will be get recorded, right?
Yes, absolutely right.
While doing on mobile.
Yes. So suppose you there was question. Say suppose you you can open PPT, PDF, anything, and you can start recording. And so if your camera is on, then it would capture a camera. And so both the thing. Viva, you can show with any with the document or something.
Means you can do the both the things, like your screen also will be on and your camera will be also on, right?
Right, right, right. Absolutely. Okay. Yes. Yes, Sonali ma'am, you have any queries, Sonali ma'am?
Yes, sir, we can trim the video.
Trim,
Yes, edit is there. I'll just show you now. I made a video. I'll just show you now how to edit one. But I think the better you try it or hands-on, you'll understand it more. So now let's say I'm going to my X recorder. And we made a few like trial videos. Now I want to edit this.
Now I can explain data.
Now over here, there's an edit option. Okay? Now able to see?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So there are a lot of options. I can trim it accordingly. If I want, I want to trim this. Then I can choose like from where I want it to be trimmed. I'm just trimming it. Now, if I want to increase or decrease the speed of my explanation, if I want to make it a little bit slow, I can do that. If I want to make it fast, that can also happen. Then I can, if I want to add background music, that's also possible. Now, if I want to add any text over there, let's say this is an might also, if I can something like that and choose the color of it. I can change the font of it if I want. By just magnify it, or if that's possible. Okay. So now in this way, I can add image. That if you want to add some caption image, you can do that. Now, if I want to change the ratio, like if for a particular view, I want to make it broader, smaller, for Instagram view, something like that. That's options there.
Okay. I hope we have answered your question, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah. So, I think almost all options are there. You can crop it also. If the screen, you feel that somewhere it's more, you don't want them to see the bigger screen. You just want them to see this much. And that's also possible. You can crop that particular part. In this way, there are a lot of features. Further, if you want to share it, if you have your YouTube linked to your school's YouTube channel, like we had done on Nextop, the same way you have to do it on your YouTube app in your phone as well, that you have to sign in with your account, which you have the account you use for operating that channel. Then when in share, if I click on YouTube, I can simply directly upload it to my YouTube channel.
Yes,
similarly, I can write my time.
Actually, you said that we can. Hello?
And upload.
Yes, ma'am.
Actually, you said that we can upload our video from that site to YouTube, right? So that time we need to enter our something, login or something over there, or it will be get connected directly?
In this, what happens is
what you have to do pre-hand. Right when that option doesn't come to enter your login. See, in your school, in your YouTube app, in your phone, you would have been logged in as in your Gmail account, right? Whichever Gmail account you're using for operating that.
Yes.
Yeah. So either what you can do is you can connect that Gmail account to your channel. Or if you're using a different email ID for that channel, then you have to log in with that. Now, in my YouTube app, let's say in this is my YouTube app.
Before I need to
there's a support school app. Yeah, it's better if you do beforehand, because then when you click on YouTube, it will get directly uploaded to YouTube. Then that, even if you don't have a channel, then you have to create a channel and all that steps will require time.
Hmm.
Okay. I think it's better to log in to the channel.
And even if it gets to your YouTube channel, that also is fine. Anyways, if you're going to add it to LMS or something, then anything would be fine. Only thing is that the video has to be uploaded.
Yeah, anything. If you have your own personal channel also, that's also okay.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Yes. Do we have any more queries on this? It's a very good tool, and it could be of made use in this time when we have to create our videos, lot of videos.
And over then here again, my record tab had gone because I had kept it above. So whenever you generally start, the record tab comes on the left hand side. Like let's say over here. So when I open the record tab, I'm able to see settings, home. If I want to use any tools, like if I want to activate the brush, if I have not, you can activate it from here. Then further, I can click on record and then start. I don't want it, that's also possible. Or I can simply click record over here and it will start. So I feel personally that it's very easy to record and very easy to edit as well. Because generally whenever we make it on desktop, editing becomes more hard, but on mobile phones, it's very easy.
Also, what we can do is, suppose some YouTube video is there. Like Vibha, you can play any YouTube video, and from there also we can show some part of it, like 1 minute of that video. We can pause it, we can explain it, and again we can proceed with that video.
So before Zoom, whenever we share screen of I think so that will be possible because I'm logged in with you. One sec. And just stop. For a YouTube video, now let's say you have created your own video and you or any other video, I'll just go to my videos. Okay, so now let's say for this video only, I'll just mute my speaker. And if you are making a video of based on another video where you want to show that video, but you want your voice to be there, your explanatory voice.
This is image, no? This is just an image?
Yes, I've made a video with it.
Okay.
Yeah, this is just an image.
No, what I'm trying to say is, play some video, like sell, some video and that.
Gravitation. As we have learned, the phenomenon of
so what we can do is say we can play, play some part of video. We can explain it, and again then we can proceed further. So that can be done.
Hello.
Yes.
I'm not the mute option over
there. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Sir, can we pick the video from YouTube and edit the video which we want to, how we explain? It's only that video can edit.
ये कसा करता है तुम्हाला? जैसे YouTube से video है, तुम्ही edit करता है ना नहीं तुम्हाला YouTube से video? पण YouTube से video अपन play करून, त्याचा वो pause केला, मग अपन आपले explanation सांगणार. परत त्याला प्ले केला, परत तो पॉज केला, तसं आपण करता येतो त्याला.
येस सर. ओके.
आता हे समजा तुम्ही व्हिडिओ बनवता, मी रेकॉर्डिंग स्टार्ट करते.
फुल स्क्रीन करेल लँडस्केप मोड.
या सो नाउ लेट्स से दिस इज व्हिडिओ इज प्लेइंग. आई डोंट नो व्हिच व्हिडिओ दिस इज. ओके सो ग्रेविटेशन, लेट्स से यू आर एक्सप्लेनिंग समथिंग, यू कैन स्टॉप एंड देन गिव योर ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट दैट पर्टिकुलर व्हिडिओ. So I think my share is stopping always because whenever it's multi-facing, why is there the same thing happening?
Okay. ठीक आहे म्हणजे हे तुम्हाला करता येतं सर.
येस येस अंडरस्टँड.
ओके
थँक्यू.
I've shared that link of this app also in chat, so you can all click on that link and download this app, X-Recorder. Fine. In the tools, there's a settings. If you want to capture yourself, in tools, there's settings called as camera. You need to enable that to capture your video along with the recording. Thank you.
So I think we have covered the first part of our session, is which was ki how teachers can record their own videos, teaching videos. So we showed you two tools, which is Screenomatic, and the second was the X-Recorder. So like we tried a lot of tools and we found that these were the most easy ones, like the most user-friendly ones and easy to understand for teachers as well. So in this way, you can record your own recordings, upload it on your school's YouTube channel, and then you can integrate it into your lesson in our LMS system. So I think the second part was how to make creative or effective presentations. So for that, I'm going to show you a tool called as Canva, and it is the most common, like currently, for making presentations. And why, I'll just share all the details of why I think you should prefer it. So Canva, again, you have to just go to canva.com and sign in. I've already signed in, I think. So, load for me. Okay. Thank you, sir and ma'am. Okay. So, for Canva, if I'll just go to normal Canva, it will show you how you can go about signing in. Canva is there on phone also, but I would prefer a laptop. Desktop or laptop when you're making a presentation, because sign up, yeah, there's whenever you type Canva in Google, you can go to sign up, and I've already signed up, so by default it even if I try to go to the sign up sign it, I get logged in again. So you can go and sign up, and sign up requires just your email ID and password, nothing else. So it's very easy. So for Canva, first is key with Canva, you can design multiple things. You can, let's say now first I'll create a design, click on create a design, and then I get different options that what I want to create. So I can create multiple things, but I think for teachers, mostly the important part is the presentation or the PPTs that they show when they're designing any particular, for any particular course content or lesson content. So I'll just go to presentation. So many of you are already like familiar with Microsoft PowerPoint, but in Microsoft PowerPoint also there are limited themes and also a limited amount of things you can do. So in this, the basic advantage of Canva is that you have a lot of pre-made templates also to choose from. You can choose any, you can check out the different templates that they have and choose any part of that template also. It's not like you have to choose an entire template. Now this is one of it. I can just choose any one I want. Let's say I'm making a botany or something, a botanical lesson or something. I can choose different templates. Then I have a lot of different fonts and sizes to add. I can add photos also if I want, if I don't want background in that particular way. If I want to add photos of a particular subject, now let's say I'll just go for science. If I want to add a background picture, that also can happen. It's for a DNA. I can add photos in that presentation very easily. So the basic problem is that whenever you're working with PowerPoint, you have to either use their clip art, or you have to download something from net or Google Images and upload in your presentation. So that can have a copyright issue. Like, not even if the all images are there on Google, that doesn't mean that they, all those are free. So there is a very high chance that there might be some copyright issues or something. So what over here, you don't have to go to multi, you have to again go to Google, download that image, that insert it into PPT. You don't have to do all that with Canva. In Canva, you already have like a very big repository of images. Then also there are elements as well. If you want to add frames, if you want to get more creative, if you want to add another views, or if you want a round frame and you want something inside that round frame, that's also possible. You can add different shapes like circle, squares and horizontal, layer a lot. I think almost all shapes are available. So in case if you're doing a mathematics, something explaining like that, you can easily add the shapes and as well. You can choose the color of the shapes. You can choose the color of the template. Over here, I can go. I can choose different colors that I have. Similarly, for the template as well, I can go and I can choose any different colors I have. If I the colors that are present over here, I'm not satisfied with those. I want some different colors. I can simply go to document color. I can move the bar. I want something in blue or something in purple. And which shade of purple? You can choose the shade as well. So these all things can be done. Also, they have in elements. The best part I feel is they have a lot and lot of small elements or featured element. Like for example, right now I created a planets PPT. So I just entered planets and I got so many different planets. Now let's say I'm making another one. Now I want to put an image of Saturn. So it's already there. So like I said, they have a big repository of pictures. You can easily take it from there and upload, and then you can write in bracket whatever you feel or what you want to write about. Let's say about Saturn, you want to write some 61 moons. That's possible. For social science, I think it's already there. So there are anything you can put, whatever you are searching for, you can put it in the chat box. And that part will be shown to you. Now, say for plant, I want to put an image of a plant. So that's there. I can do that as well. So that's the best part, that you don't have to go to Google, search an image and then put that image into your presentation. You can simply go to elements, type in the element or the picture you want to insert in it. You can do that. There's also an option of adding photos as well. Then text box. In a text box, may again, you can, there's three types. Like if you want a large, okay, there's a chat. Very nice. Okay. So in case if you want to add, let's say, an explanation about this. Now I'll choose first. It's very easy. If you don't want any part, you can simply click on it and press on backspace or delete. It gets deleted. Now, when you want to make a presentation for Canva, now let's say I want to add a heading. First, I'll take a heading. I'll type in Saturn. I'll type in Saturn. By default, there'll be some font, but if you want to change the font type also, now that's also I think best part. You have a lot of fonts. You can accept like for Word. Even for Word or for any other software, there are limited amount of fonts. In Canva, there are so many different amount of fonts that you can like for if you want to make very creative images or something, is the best way to go about. Say I'm trying out some fonts. Okay, I can try different fonts. Whenever you click on that font will be automatically changed. So you can check which different fonts you want. And same ways, the bold, the alignment, where you want the image to be, that's also possible. So now I've added an image. Now I wanted to add a subheading. So by default, those headings fonts are set. If you want to change those, you simply have to expand or let it down if you want to change it manually. Now over here there's an option. Now if I want to keep it as 40, I'll keep it as 40. That's also option. I can change the font easily again. So you can have multiple fonts in a page with multiple images, and you can easily move that box here and there. If you want to make a larger box, that also is possible. So now let's say I'll just copy a content on Saturn. I have made one, I think. I'll just copy that content. So I'll show you how if we write or type in along. But I can simply copy paste from another presentation that I have. Okay, I'm adding it in this one. Okay, so now I've added like some content. Now for that also, if you want, you can make it more. You can adjust the view basically. You can adjust if you want it in smaller font and wide, or if you want it in larger font, but you want it a little broad. Those all options are there. In this way, you can control every element of your presentation. That's the basic point. Now, music I don't think is necessary, and I don't think that the music will be supported in the PDF format. There are videos, there are animation, background images. If you are designing now, let's say for this, if I want a background image of a sky or something, I can do that. It will show you an option of the background images present. There's Okay, so now I'll just say I want the background image of stars or sky. I'll change according to my click. There's some problem with downloading it, maybe. Just change another one. So you can easily change the background image. There's a lot of options you can work about. In this way, you can design your own PPTs, make it more creative, more interactive. And the best part about this is that you can save it. It automatically gets saved to your account. You don't have to, even if you like exit it at some point, those changes will be saved. Now, the best part I feel is share. So in case, I would suggest that in case if you want to review, like if you want to send it to a coordinator to review, or if you are collaborating with some other teacher and you want her to see the presentation, then you can simply type in her email ID and click on share. That's that option is there. Now let's say I'm sharing it with her. So that's option. Also, if you have made teams, you can simply make change the visibility for the teams. And I'll see that the design was shared. So I can share that design. Now, if I want to, let's say, upload this design or this PPT to my LMS system, so I can simply click on download. There's an option of download. Then in download also, there are different types. Do you want to download it as a PDF or as an image, a high quality image, small quality image? That also is there. If you want to download only a particular page, that also you can select, or you can select all. By default, it selects all, but in case if you have like preference, that can also be done. And just click on download and it will easily download it on your laptop device, whichever device you're using. Okay, chat, I'm not able to see the chat. Nice app, great effort. Okay. So, yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Shilpi, ma'am, for the compliment. So, yeah.
So, the best thing about this is it's completely cloud-based. So, it's just you need to open it and, you know, from anywhere you can access this. So from anywhere, just you go to the Canvas, you log in, and you can access your presentations, and you can share it and everything. So it's not limited to a PC computer or something.
And you can check your log. They get automatically saved. Even if you have made something like you are working on something and you couldn't complete, those get automatically saved to the drive. I think I'm not able to see my designs. Okay. In this way, I can. There's an option of your designs in below. You'll be able to see all the designs that you have made. So I've downloaded it now. Let's say and upload it. So in this way, you can make your own more creative presentations. In this way. So further, one part I think I left out was how to make your school different or your presentations different. So basically, in designing language, what happens is they have a same theme or a set theme or a set font. So whenever like, or at least the title page. Now, if you keep for all your presentation for your school, if you're keeping the same title page, so whenever a person sees that presentation or opens up and sees the first title page, they know that this is made by that particular entity. So for right now, let's say I've selected a theme, I've selected a font, and I have added our logo. So in this way, you can add your school logo and you can select a theme and a font for your school logo. So if you have observed, like on Study Cloud, basically is what I observed, that all of their presentations are in the same format or in the same theme. But right, like making same theme doesn't make sense. But at least for the first title card or the title image, I think you should make with the same font or the same template for entire school with your font, with your school's logo on top. So then whenever that content is opened by anyone, it's known. Like after a time, once people start using it, they'll know. Whenever they'll see the first frame itself, they'll know that this is made by this particular school. So after a year or so, you don't have to rely on any other online content. In this way, you can create your own school's online content. But just the basic suggestion is that whenever you're creating for graphic design or designing language, that at least the first title image should always be in same with the same template and the same font and with the logo of your company or your school or whichever thing you're using as a logo that can go over here. And that basically becomes your designing language. So whenever anyone sees that, they'll know that it's made by your school. So within
you can for the videos you have created, you use this and this, so that you can show how you know how you do it. Means the videos which you create, I think you use same that blue screen and
the same title template.
Yes. So that you can show, you know, how 2-3 videos you are using the same.
Yeah. So let's say like I have my own title templates, but I'll just create one template and I'll add to our trial video. So
you know, no need to add. Just show them like this is how you are creating same this.
Okay. So in YouTube, I'll go to YouTube.
No. Here also you can mention.
No, sir. I'll just have to show them that all the videos have the same title card.
Okay.
So it looks like it's from our. Okay. So for our videos, we already every time whenever we make a video, we have the same background, the same font, and the same logo. So whenever these videos are opened, it is automatically like it clicks that it is made by us or it's made by our team. So in this way, whichever video that you have, like right now, let's say we have this solar system video. Now, for this particular video, I have to go to edit, I think. I have to go to the YouTube video. So whenever you upload video, there's an option of uploading a thumbnail. But right now, let's say I want to show you how like the, how that option looks like also.
So once you have uploaded video, you can't change thumbnail?
You can change, sir. That's what I'm doing currently. Like I'm uploading the... opening the YouTube studio. So in your YouTube studio, you will be able to access all your videos, and if there is some edition required or addition required to that videos that can be done. So now let's say for this video, I want to change something. I'll just go and click on details. Now I can change the title. I can change the description of that video. I can, if I want to change the visibility, that's also possible. So over here, there's an option where you can see upload thumbnail. If you have, you can simply drag and drop it over there, or you can choose something from your file. Now I'm just choosing an image. Yeah, so in this way, you can just add an image to that video, and I'll just click on save. So whenever that video is seen, this will be the title image of that video. So in, right now I've just added a random title image. You can make your own title images. Like I said, we have made for our own videos. You can do that. Go back. Once you do the same title image for all your videos, like if you're able to see my screen now, for all our videos, we have the same title image and the same font with our logo. So in this way, you can create for your own school one template where the title image has a same same background, same font, and this your school's logo. So whenever your videos, whenever you are uploading it on your school's channel, then all the videos will be. It is basically like branding only. Like anyone who opens those, like whenever your teachers or anyone opens that videos knows that this is made from your school's end. So in this way, like I said, you can have your own content. You don't have to rely on any other content. Basically, so I think I have explained Canva. Any doubts or any questions regarding those, you can ask.
Okay, I think when they try it, they'll be able to. So, how was the feedback regarding the session? Was this useful? You can unmute yourself and so that we understand either we are going it in the right with the proper direction or.
Hello, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm from Bharati Vidyapeeth Kolhapur branch. Vanashi Kulkarni here.
Yes, ma'am.
So just I wanted to say hats off to you, both of you and your team, that so fluently, so very nicely, you are explaining everything to us. And you are introducing us to a very new technology, which is very difficult to explain actually. You are not only explaining, but we are clearing our doubts also. So we are very thankful for that, sir. Thank you.
Thank you,
ma'am.
Yes, Sonali, ma'am, you have any query?
Sir, sir, for जो background है हर slide के लिए हम लोग different set कर सकते हैं ना सिर्फ जो फर्स्ट टाइटल स्लाइड के लिए रहेगा बैकग्राउंड वो कॉमन रहेगा सबके लिए.
हम ऐसा सजेस्ट हम क्या सजेस्ट करते हैं कि जैसे अपने स्कूल के अभी इतने बहुत अलग अलग टीचर्स हो गए ना, और तो व्हाट वी सजेस्ट इज कि सब जन टाइटल जो स्क्रीन है फर्स्ट स्क्रीन वो सेम रखेंगे. स्कूल का नाम आएगा, उसका फॉर्मेट है ना बाय टीचर, टीचर का नाम आएगा नीचे और टॉपिक का नाम आएगा, तो वो जो फर्स्ट स्लाइड है वो सेम होना चाहिए.
Yes,
जैसे हम लोग बैकग्राउंड चेंज कर सकते हैं.
Yeah, you can easily change backgrounds for this particular session. Only the first slide we are suggesting to keep the same. And similarly for the video, for adding the title slide is similar. Like for all your videos, so that then all those videos and all those PPTs or contents will be only for of your school. So after a time it will be realized. Anyone will be opening it, then they'll say, "Ha, Baba, this is made by this school."
Okay. Thank you so much. Thanks, sir and ma'am, for the
thank you, sir.
Very nice presentation. हम लोग उसको आगे भी यूज कर सकते हैं, मतलब फॉर रिसर्च सेंटर के लिए भी ये पीपीटीज बहुत अच्छी तरह से यूज हो सकती है. थैंक्स.
थैंक यू एक्चुअली वी थॉट टुडे देयर विल बी मोर पार्टिसिपेंट्स यू नो, सो वी ट्राइड टू गो टू अनदर प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर देयर विल बी बट देयर वर पार्टिसिपेंट्स. But you know, afterwards, if you missed it out, that way. So almost there were 100 participants today also. Yes. Is Asmita ma'am ready?
Yes, sir. सर आपने जो बताया रिकॉर्डर का, दो ऑप्शन तो बहुत अच्छे हैं आपके. एक्स रिकॉर्डर वाला तो बहुत ही अच्छा है, पर और एक ऑप्शन है काइन मास्टर, अगर उसके बारे में आप अगर कुछ इन्फॉर्मेशन दे सकते हैं तो बहुत अच्छा होगा सर.
अब क्या इसका उसका फंक्शनलिटी क्या है काइन
मास्टर? हाँ, हाउ टू मतलब हम कैसे उसको रिकॉर्ड कर सकते हैं. काइन मास्टर मेरे पास है पर मैंने यूज नहीं किया उसको.
तो मतलब but for I'll recommend X recorder better than kind master because it has more editing tools than that.
Okay.
And then I think isme we can record our own video, so that is I think a very additional tool because abhi videos to kya hota hai, videos to itne sare aate hain, you know, means agar aap YouTube pe bhi dalo kahin pe bhi dalo, but school abhi students ko kya lagega ki hamare teacher se aaya video ya mere teacher se aaya video, to wo itna wo dhyan se dekhenge.
और कैनवा में जो हमने प्रेजेंटेशन बनाया था सर, तो एक बार अपलोड करने के बाद हम फिर से उसको एडिट कर सकते हैं क्या? आई थिंक मुझे लगा कि मैंने जो बनाया है उसमें और कुछ मुझे अच्छा करना है. और एक डाउट है कि इसमें जो अदर इंस्टेड ऑफ इंग्लिश जो लैंग्वेजेस है उसको हम गूगल पे टाइप करके ही यूज कर सकते हैं. यहाँ पर भी लैंग्वेजेस के लिए अदर जो आपने फॉन्ट बताया था मुझे
टाइप करके पेस्ट करना पड़ेगा. आप टाइप कॉपी पेस्ट कर सकते हैं इंग्लिश में, टाइप नहीं कर सकते. ओके सो अभी लेट्स से मैं ना कोई पुराना है मुझे बस ओपन करना है, तो मैं भी इसे ओपन. जो भी आप एडिटिंग करेंगे वो सेव होगा ऑटोमेटिकली.
माय ड्राइव
पे इट देयर टू कंटिन्यू. या सो नाउ लेट्स से आई वांट टू एडिट, नाउ आई विल जस्ट ऐड सम वन मोर सेंटेंस टू इट दैट्स पॉसिबल. लाइक आई एम एडिंग से वन मोर सेंटेंस. आई कैन डू एनीथिंग कैन बी इजीली एडिटेड आफ्टरवर्ड्स एज वेल. सी ओवर हियर यू आर एबल टू सी सेविंग चेंजेस, सो ऑटोमेटिकली व्हेनेवर यू मेक इफ यू डोंट वांट यू कैन अंडू इट.
और इसमें जैसे ये पेज है, अब ये पेज ऐसे कैसे कॉपी करना है, तो इधर ऑप्शन है प्लस कर दिस डबल टू प्लस प्लस के तो ब्लैंक होगा और वो डुप्लीकेट है, इस पे क्लिक करोगे तो वैसे का
डुप्लीकेट कॉपी आएगा. ओके सर. ओके थैंक यू बोथ ऑफ यू.
थैंक यू.
यू कैन चेंज द सीक्वेंस आल्सो, यू कैन मूव अप और मूव डाउन दैट पर्टिकुलर पेज इफ यू वांट टू चेंज द सीक्वेंस, दैट्स आल्सो पॉसिबल.
तो ऑलमोस्ट सब ऑप्शन है इसमें बेटर देन यू नो प्रेजेंटेशन पावर पॉइंट विद प्रेजेंटेशंस. यस anything, any other queries?
Any more questions or queries? Sir, I think there it's someone has started screen sharing.
Yeah, I think I missed it.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes, good afternoon.
I'm from Bharti Vidyapeeth Kadega.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, I have not joined that LMS session.
You wanted a demo also?
LMS demo.
Yeah, I'll share a file. Yeah. I'll share a file with you in the chat box that contains all our LMS the videos also and also our documents as well. Mm-hmm. You can check those out.
Also, tomorrow we are planning to have an LMS session, so we'll update you on the same. Yes. Hope we were able to, you know, the time you spent with us, you were able to get all the required details and we were able to, you know, help you out. So we can conclude the session, I think, Yuga, if there are no queries. You can try this and if there are any new tools we get, you know, then we'll update, you know, we can have sessions further on this. Yes.
Okay, so thank you all teachers for your time and patience.
Thank you.
Thank you.